doing discussion related to models. Why models are important? What do they do for us? Why is it important for us to study models and all that? So if you have any question related to that, I am essentially here to answer your questions. With that, I will also talk about the format of exam. What kind of questions you will be asked, what will be the format, and everything. Okay, do you have any question about Gerbner's model that we discussed last time? How many of you got the chance to read the notes, PDF notes that I uploaded on Moodle? Can you please raise your hands? Please raise your hands, whoever actually read the notes to prepare for exam, which is the day after tomorrow. Nobody read the notes because I don't see anyone raising hands. What about you, Amna, Muhammad Yasser, Fatma, Ahmed?
Ma'am, I did open the file, but then I got all lazy. Ke abhi time hai, so I kind of bailed on it.
Beta, you have only today's day and tomorrow's day. That's it. That's it. You should have actually given some attention to notes. It is important for you to know that please do not confine your preparation to PowerPoint slides only, because that are only highlights. In order to prepare well, you must consider what's that called? You must consider notes in detail. Theek hai? Chalein ji. But anyways, if you do not have any question, I'll talk very briefly about the Gerbner's model one more time, because this is what we were doing last time, and then I'll talk about the format of paper, the format of exam. Okay, I'll repeat the information, and I feel like it bears repeating that you will have your first exam on April 9, from 9 a.m. to 9:50 a.m. Okay, the exam's worth is 35% for your final evaluation. All right, this is the model. This was our last model that we discussed in our class, and this model is included in your exam that I'm going to give you on Friday. Acha, I began from this discussion that Gerbner's model has two versions. It comes in verbal form and it comes in diagram form as well. So here you see the verbal form, and I told you that verbal form will make more sense for you after you have actually learned the graphical form, the diagram form as well. And the caveat here, I told you that all elements that we see in the verbal form, they are not, it's not necessary that in a single situation you can use all of these elements. Okay. Before I began explaining the model, I told you the key. What does the letter E denote to? What does the letter M denote to? What is E1 and all that? And here is the description of model. I will briefly repeat it for you, that whenever there is an event, a machine or a person perceives the event, and E1 is the perception of event that is perceived by either reporter or his machine. Machine can be his microphone, his camera, or anything. And then let's say now this person, M, he wants to disseminate the message. He wants to transmit the message. So he may use any channel or at any medium to transmit his message, and his message can come in any form. SE means statement about event. What we see here is that Gerbner's model actually is a chain of perception, production, and then further perception. Okay, now excuse me, with this I explain you another example. Let's say there is an event which is related to condensation of moisture in the air. I told you what is the meaning of condensation. So water condensation is a process whereby whenever gas vapors, they come into contact with moisture in air, they are transformed into water droplets. So let's say there is an event which is related to condensation of moisture in the air, and there is a reporter who sees this event happening and he perceives it like rain. So rain is the perception of this event, and now he wants to transmit this event. He will generate a statement about the event and he will send it to another channel. Here I gave you the example. Let's say there was an event which was perceived by a news agency, and that news agency further wants to transmit the event, and then it is further taken up by a newspaper organization. And similarly, this message can further be transferred by, let's say this was taken up by an international newspaper, and this is further taken up by a national newspaper. So what we see is that according to Gerbner's model, the transmission of message is a chain of perception, production, perception, and then further production. So to repeat, Gerbner's model says that the messages that get to us through mass media, they are a chain of perception, production, perception, production, perception, production. What Gerbner is trying to say here is that that whatever message that gets to us by media persons, by reporters, by journalists, it is based on their perception, how they have perceived the event to be. That is how the message that gets to us can actually be different from the actual message. As you can see, that Gerbner emphasizes that information, especially transmission of information, is a subjective and selective process. I am stopping the sharing of my screen for a moment, and I'm writing this information in the chat box. That according to Gerbner, the production of information is a subjective and selective process. Now, what is the meaning of subjective? Who can tell? Because this is something that we discussed in our very first class, I remember. What is the meaning of subjective? Who can tell? This is something that we have already discussed in our first class. What is the meaning of a subjective piece of information?
Ma'am, the brief jo kafi zyada expand ho information, yani jaisa aapne example li thi hame hamare jo question exams hote the unke hawale se, objectives jo hain wo limited hote hain,
shabash,
limited time mein, aur usme limited information hum bata sakte hain, balki jab subjective ki baat karte hain uske andar hum zyada kuch bata sakte hain.
Shabash, Abdullah. Abdullah, you are very close, but your understanding. Okay, I asked you when I explained this term. Ji, go ahead. Go ahead.
Subjective is like something that is having some specific qualities.
Like what, or relating to qualities?
Or relating to some.
Something like that. Acha, ab isko sun le, and you should. Somebody raised his hand. May I know who raised hand? Okay, Amna, go ahead.
Ma'am, subjective is something we can explain our feelings, or we can give our opinions, brief explanation of our opinions.
Yeah. Okay, listen to this very carefully. And I am surprised to see that your concept is still not clear, because this is something that is based on my very first lecture, and it is also available on Moodle in the form of a recording. Listen, subjective is something that is based on personal opinion. Subjective is personal. Objective is that the reporter, the writer, he does not let his personal opinion to come into a new story. Okay? This is how subjective is different from objective. I will repeat. Subjective is, for example, if I say that I like the current provincial government, that is a subjective opinion. I'm talking about my personal personal liking, disliking. Objective is that you do not let your personal liking or disliking, your biases affect your opinion affect the story. So for example, what we see in news is all objective, because journalists are not supposed to talk about their likings, their dislikings, their biases. They are only reporting the fact as it is. However, in subjective, you give your personal opinion. Does that all make sense?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
Can anyone repeat this information for me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, go ahead, please.
Ma'am, subjectivity is something that is based on the personal opinion.
Yeah.
And objectivity is something jo personal opinion pe based nahi hoti. For example,
shabash. You can say that subjectivity is something that is influenced by personal opinion. Objectivity is something that is not influenced by personal opinion. Now I'll give you two statements and you will tell me which one is objective and which one is subjective. Okay, I give you a statement and I say that the Prime Minister talked to media, talked to Pakistani media last night, and he urged the public to take strong measures to fight the third wave of COVID. Is this statement objective or subjective? Do you want me to repeat the statement? The statement, yeah, go ahead, Amna. Amna, go ahead.
Ma'am, I think objective.
Shabash. And what's the reason?
Ma'am, reason is because he's not sharing his personal opinion.
The reporter,
that's why it's objective.
The reporter is not sharing his personal opinion. If I am a reporter, I am only reporting what I have seen or what I have observed. I am saying that Prime Minister talked to media last night and he urged the public to take strong measures to fight against the third wave of COVID. This is just a reporting and it doesn't include my own opinion. Subjective is when your opinion is influenced by your personal feelings or personal biases. Now compare it with another statement. I say Prime Minister of the country talked to media last night. He seemed very anxious about the spread of the third wave of COVID in the country. Now, is this subjective or objective?
Subjective.
Shabash. Because this is personal. Maybe Prime Minister seemed anxious to me. It is possible he did not seem anxious to other people in the audience. This is subjective. Theek hai? Okay, if I say I like wearing blue color, or let's say if I say I like FC College because it has a gorgeous campus. Theek hai?
Subjective.
Shabash. Dekhen, the reason of my liking is FC College's campus, and it can be different from another person. And any other person can say, I like FC College because of its focus on liberal arts education. Theek hai? This is personal. Because another person's opinion about FC College's liking is different from my opinion. This is how subjective is. If I say this statement that FC College was established in 1864 and it offers an American style education, is this objective or subjective?
Objective.
Shabash. it is objective. Objective because I am only describing fact. I am not giving a statement which is based on my personal influence. Does that explain, Haseeb? Does that explain?
Yes, ma'am, it is.
Okay. When I say I like FC College because it offers liberal arts education, I am giving an opinion which is based on my personal feeling. Okay? However, if I say FC College is an institution which was established in 1864 and it offers an American style education, here I'm only describing a fact. I'm not talking about anything which is based on my personal feeling. All right. With this, I am done with my, I was trying to help you develop your understanding about subjectivity and objectivity. With that, I was also helping you prepare for your exam, which is the day after tomorrow. And I was saying that Gerbner's model is subjective. Gerbner's model talks about subjectivity of information. See, when it says that there is an event, it is perceived by a reporter, and then it is produced by him according to his perception, according to reporter's perception. Isn't that subjectivity? ठीक है, subjectivity है ना? जैसे if there is a reporter and he talks about this idea that government is recently announcing single national curriculum and it is a really good effort of the government towards the enhancement of primary education. ठीक है, this is subjective. Reporter is giving his talking about his personal opinion, and he so dekhe, there was an event where the provincial education minister was talking about SNC, single national curriculum. The reporter goes there for the coverage of the event. He sees, he listens to the information. Excuse me. He listens to this information and then he says that the government is currently taking this decision for the improvement of education in the province and it is a really good decision. Now, saying this, that it is a really good decision, it means the reporter is letting his personal feelings influence the information. Theek hai? This is what Gerbner says, that reporter goes, attends the event, perceives the event and then reproduces the event according to his perception. That is how he says that the information that comes through us in media, according to Gerbner, it is subjective and selective. Selective, jaise maine yaad, I remember I told you that consider the fire incident that happened at Hafiz Center. A reporter goes there. Abdullah, I'll take your question in a minute. A reporter goes there and with his camera, let's say he take pictures of building on fire only from front. He doesn't take the pictures from the sides, from the back. So he's only showing, his camera is only showing one side of the picture to us. That is how it is selective. So what Gerbner says, that's to explain the statement that I wrote in the chat box, this is what it means, that according to Gerbner, the production of information according to Gerbner's model is subjective and selective. So this is how Gerbner's model helps us understand concept of production of information. And essentially Gerbner says that information in media is actually a chain of production, perception. Excuse me. Ji Abdullah, you wanted to say something?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, अक्सर हम लोग देखते हैं कि एक incident होता है तो उसके अंदर जो reporter है वो बाकी लोगों की जो है वो राय जो है उसको उसका part बना लेता है news report का.
Witnesses, so, yeah.
Witnesses, तो उनकी अपनी जो है ओपिनियन होती है. अब उनकी बेसिस पे अगर हम किसी का यानी इस तरह ओपिनियंस आगे दे रहे हैं तो वो हमारी ऑब्जेक्टिव होगी कि सब्जेक्टिव होगी?
On the basis of the opinions of witnesses?
Yes, ma'am.
So the opinion that comes from a witness is subjective. ठीक है? And if you are reporting that opinion as it is, then it is objective. But if you are reporting in a way that you also talk about your personal feeling, then it is subjective. Does this answer your question, Abdullah?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
But the objective is that you are conveying the information as it is. The moment the information you transfer or transmit is affected by your personal feeling, it becomes subjective.
मैम अक्सर हम ये भी तो देखते हैं कि रिपोर्टर ने वहाँ पे इंटरव्यूज किए होते हैं पहले से और वो एक यानी जो एक राय देते हैं एंड पे कि लोगों का ये कहना है तो बेसिकली उसके अंदर उसके अपने भी कुछ कई बार आ जाते हैं और कई बार वो बात इस तरह कवर्ड होती है बेसिकली उसके अंदर मुख्तलिफ लोगों की मुख्तलिफ राय होती है लेकिन रिपोर्टर एक ही बात कन्वे करते हैं आगे.
It's a very good question, Abdullah. If you, I think you were not with us when we did our first class, but I did do the recording and my recording is available in the very first folder on Moodle. We did talk about the same idea that you are discussing right now. Excuse me. And the idea was that objectivity is an idea that is really, really hard to practice. Although objectivity is something that is required from journalists, their profession demands that they stay objective. But this should also be remembered that objectivity actually is a very difficult idea to practice because many times we are influenced by our personal feelings, by our personal likings, and we cannot resist them to get reflected into our news stories. Does that answer your question, Abdullah?
Yeah.
Challenge. Now with this, I have explained everything related to Gerbner's model. If you have any question related to any other model, you can ask me now. And let me tell you all the syllabus that we have covered so far, each and everything is available on Moodle. It's included in your exam, which will happen the day after tomorrow on Friday. Now, these are important things for you to consider. Number one, your exam will begin at 9 sharp and the portal will close at 50 minutes past 9 sharp. Okay? Although, please listen to this very carefully. This is very important for you all to know. Although this is an open book exam, which means you can consider your notes, you can consider your lecture or anything helping material to answer questions. But with this, please be mindful of the fact that you are time bound to take this exam. You will be on a clock. You will only be given 50 minutes to take this exam. Okay? You will not be given any extra time. No extra time. Now, अच्छा अब इसके साथ ही let me tell you another thing. The format. Another important thing is make sure your devices are fully charged. Make sure you have a backup plan in case of power outage, because once the portal closes, and if there is a student who comes to me that can you please open up the portal one more time? No. The rule is the portal only allows you one attempt. If the portal is closed and you are not done with your exam, it means when I let you take the exam again, the portal will start over, which means now you are doing another attempt, a second attempt. So in order to be uniform, in order to have a uniform policy with all of you, in order to be fair, I do not allow more than one attempt. So it is not possible that there can be a retake. If for some reason you miss your exam, then I deal with students case by case. I need to see that you really, really had a genuine reason because of which you missed your exam with evidence. And then what I can do is in order to give you a makeup, I can give you an oral exam. Currently, the university's policy emphasizes oral exam because it minimizes cheating and it also kind of lessens the workload on teachers. Okay? This is my policy. So what I am trying to say here is that please take every effort to take your exam on time and do not miss it. There is a student in your class, Abdullah, Muhammad Abdullah. He has already spoken with me. He has a reason and I have noted his name. Whoever has written to me that, ma'am, I am having this problem on that day and for this reason I cannot take the exam, I have noted their names. And I am asking them to send me their evidence to verify that they have a genuine reason to miss the exam. And that is why I emphasize that you ensure a strong internet connection and you also ensure a backup plan so that you do not miss out exam. Again, there is a strict there is a strict time limit for you to take your exam. You will only be given 50 minutes, not more than that. Theek hai? Although an open book exam, I highly recommend that you do not waste your time asking your friends for help or asking, because this is not going to be helpful. Why? I am a kind of teacher who never asks for or who never assesses students for their memorizing ability. My only aim to give you exam is to assess your concept clarity and to assess the application, your application of knowledge. Okay? Now, let me tell you what kind of questions, what is going to be the format. So the exam is going to be of 35 marks. Its weightage is also 35%. You will be given 20 multiple choice questions. Now listen to this very carefully. You will have 20 multiple choice questions. Each question will have 3 to 4 options. You will have to choose the one best option. Although other options may seem closer, yes, they may seem closer, that is how they may be a bit confusing. However, your job is to choose the best possible option. To repeat, although other options may seem close or closer, however, there will be only one best option and your job is to choose that best option while answering multiple choice questions. There are going to be 20 multiple choice questions and each question will have 1 point. Okay? For the rest of the 15 marks, you will get an essay type question. Okay? Which means that I will ask you to write an answer of 200 words maximum. But 200 words mean just one paragraph. So that question, what kind of question can that be? That question can be, for example, I just talked about Gerbner's model. And I can say, I can ask you a question that according to Gerbner's model, the production of information is a chain of production, perception, and production, perception. Explain how is that possible? Or how can you translate Gerbner's model into the reporting of any event? Remember, I gave you the example of fire incident at Hafiz Center. Maybe you can come up with another example. And when I ask you for example, I will write specifically that please explain this model with an example other than the one that we discussed in class. Okay? And that question is going to be of 15 marks, 1-5. Now listen to this again very carefully. For that 15 marks essay question, you will also receive a rubric. I mean, at the top, either at the top of the question or at the back bottom of the question, I will give you a rubric. Rubric will tell you that how I am going to assess your answer for this question. Okay? And while you answer, make sure that you follow the rubric, because I will assess your answer exclusively on the basis of the rubric that I will give you there. For example, I will write there are 3 marks. For example, there are 3 marks for explaining, let's say, production, perception, process. There are 3 marks for this or thing. Like this is, there will be a complete rubric, so you shouldn't be confused about it. Now, any question? Any question about the format? फातिमा बेटे कोई क्वेश्चन?
नो मैम नॉट।
अच्छा एक चीज के बारे में आप केयरफुल रहे। सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई हैव आस्क्ड यू टू एक्सप्लेन फॉर द एसे टाइप क्वेश्चन, नॉट फॉर मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन हियर, ओनली फॉर एसे टाइप क्वेश्चन। सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई आस्क्ड दैट वट इज हाउ डू यू एक्सप्लेन व्हाट्स दैट कॉल्ड फ्रैंक डैन्स हेलिकल मॉडल, ठीक है, and how do you think this model is important for studying the dynamic nature of media? Aapko pata hai humne discuss kiya tha ki dance model is specially important for studying dynamic like ever changing nature of media. Now why is that? Now you have to explain that because the model goes in a helical form, in the spring like form, and it tells it actually explains evolution of something. This is how you can explain. Please explain in your own words. Do not lift material from internet. Do not copy your answer from internet. See, I am a teacher who has been in the business of teaching for almost 13, 14 years now. ठीक है? And I know that from the word choices, the way of punctuation, the way a student has constructed a sentence and everything, I can know if the student has written this content or if he has copied it from a book or maybe or from internet. Please, there will be in the rubric, there will be separate marks for writing answer in your own words. If you are copying it from somewhere, you are going to lose marks and you do not want that to happen. Please be very, very careful about that. ठीक है? Also, when you are giving examples, give examples from your routine life. Give examples that are local to our culture. In the books, in the notes that I have shared with you, most examples are from Western culture. And also do not give me the same examples that we have discussed in class. Come up with your own examples. ठीक है? Because there will be separate marks for that. I highly recommend that you do not copy material from internet, especially for your subjective, for your essay type question. ठीक है? Any question?
No, ma'am.
ठीक है? It's pretty simple. There are going to be 20 multiple choice question and then an essay type question. An essay type question will be of 15 marks and you can easily divide time. Maybe you can select 25 minutes for doing multiple choice questions and then 25 minutes for doing essay type question, for which I am going to ask you to write only 200 to 250 words, not more than that. And 250 words means just one paragraph. ठीक है? Do you have any question? I told you today that I'll talk about the format of the exam. Again, when you get essay type question, you will get a rubric as well. जैसे about Chenin and Weaver's model, just to give you example, what kind of questions can be asked, I can ask you that what is your understanding of a semantic level problem in communication and explain your answer with an example. मैंने आपको example दी थी class में. When I asked you to explain semantic level problem in communication with an example, I would ask you to give me an example which is different from the one that I discussed in class. ठीक है? ठीक है? तो आप अपनी तैयारी करें. You should prepare according to that.
मैम 50 मिनट्स बहुत कम नहीं होंगे, क्योंकि एट टाइम्स अगर किसी ने लॉन्ग क्वेश्चन अटेम्प्ट करना है तो कुछ सोचना भी होता है बीच में कि इसमें ये पार्ट डालें ये पार्ट ना डालें एंड ऑल, तो 50 मिनट्स से थोड़ा सा ज्यादा टाइम हो जाए लाइक एन आवर और सो.
बच्चे फातिमा थैंक यू फॉर योर कंसर्न, आई अप्रिशिएट दैट यू ब्रॉट दिस अप, बट यू सी द थिंग इज वी ऑलरेडी हैव वेरी लिमिटेड सिलेबस फॉर दिस एग्जाम एंड दिस इज एन एग्जाम दैट इट्स नॉट समथिंग दैट इट्स कमिंग आउट ऑफ नोवेयर. दिस इज एन एग्जाम व्हिच वाज अनाउंस्ड 2 वीक्स इन एडवांस, व्हिच मींस आई एम एक्सपेक्टिंग यू टू बी वेरी वेल प्रिपेयर्ड. आई हैव टोल्ड यू द काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस दैट मे बी आस्क्ड. So in your preparation, when you read the notes, always think about relevant examples. So that when you go in actual exam, you are actually ready to write about it. again, there are only 3 or 4 models that are included in this exam, which is not a big deal. And I honestly think that 50 minutes is a really good length of time to take this exam, if you are prepared.
All right.
I'm sorry, I cannot go beyond 50 minutes. I only want to give you this exam during my class time.
No issues, ma'am. It's fine.
Ji, bache, koi aur? Shiza, yes. While you explain the question, explain it very briefly and then give the example. You may want to rehearse it. I have told you each and everything. I have told you the format. So when you prepare, when you are reading a model, particular model, think about relevant example so that your example always comes in handy. It's not like you have to spend your time thinking about relevant example. You are prepared. You should be prepared. Bete, I always give consideration to language accuracy. If your language is full of grammar or spelling mistakes, you are going to lose marks. Please be very careful about that. Okay. If you do not have any other question, Daud asks, what's the format of the exam? Daud, I just explained in detail. There are 20 marks, multiple choice. There are 20 multiple choice questions. Each is of 1 point, in total 20. And then there is just one essay type question, which will be of 15 marks. And you will also get a rubric for that question. Please pay attention to rubric while you write the answer of that question. Okay. Okay, bachcha, I'm going to end this session now. Theek hai? I wish you very best of luck for your exam on Friday. Now I'll see you all on Monday. Okay? Thank you and goodbye.
Okay, ma'am.
Thank you and goodbye.